The Darien Gap is a unique forest because it's the link between South and North America. Thanks to the absence of roads, it's really not disturbed, but we also know almost nothing about it. Some people estimate that 25% of the species are endemic to here.
In May this year, we went to the Darien Gap because we wanted to research on some populations of tundra frogs that have been in contact with the chytrid, which is a fungi that has been affecting the species of amphibians all over the world, and it has been causing extinctions and population declines.
Driving through the Inter-American Highway is really interesting. You see a lot of deforestation. It's also a very rural area where you see a lot more indigenous people. And at the end of the road, there is a town called Chavisa. And here is where the road really ends in a football soccer field. From Chavisa, we took a boat for about an hour. And boats are the main form of transportation in the Darien Gap. You see a lot of the towns are next to the river, and people use the rivers to transport food and building materials, for example. After these, we took a pickup truck for about an hour, which took us to the beginning of the trail. We hiked for about 3 hours, and we ended up in the field station of Rancho Frijol. So once you go into the Darien Gap, you go into the forest, and it's beautiful, it's very pristine. The forest is not disturbed. You see really tall trees. You see a lot of vines, a lot of palms, and the reason is because trees are so high and the canopy is so close that there's really few light that goes into the understory. There's a lot of diversity of plants, and then you also see lots of birds, lots of wildlife. You feel how the forest is really old growth.
The frogs that we study, they breed during the rainy season.
That means that the everyday rains a lot. So we have to be ready to be something when it's raining. We have to just sleep in the forest when it's raining. So we had to bring special hammocks that come with a rain fly, because once it rains, the forest really turns into a river. So there's a lot of water. When we are working, we look for the frogs at night, we collect them, and then the next day we process the samples and we swab them for chytrid. During the free time, we'll go out in the trails and explore, look for wildlife, and of course we'll take a break and go and enjoy the beautiful rivers and the waterfalls.
Major highlight, I think, is that the Darien used to be this mystic place out of bounds where you could not go, and it seemed some impossible place to visit. And we went there and we find this beautiful forest, really peaceful. We never felt in danger. So it turned into a place that now feels more familiar, and we want to keep going and keep doing research. So it was great to find a place that was welcoming us. Thank you.